As pediatricians, we are often confronted with the parents who are just new, and especially mothers who are keen to know how to do a normal routine care of the baby. Now, you have to understand, as mothers, there are certain things which are very unique to a baby when the baby is born. There are lots of things which seem abnormal in a baby, but are actually within normal limits. For example, a baby might sneeze about 30 times per day, have a lot of runny noses. That's a normal thing. A baby may have hiccups. That doesn't mean that a baby needs water. In fact, no baby needs water if the baby is breastfed or bottle fed till about 6 months of age. A baby may pass loose watery stools which comes out in a gush, and the color of the stools will be yellow or maybe green, maybe brown. Even greenish stools are normal. The baby may pass 24 stools in 24 hours or even one stool in a week's time. Even that's normal. Now, the baby may pass a lot of flatus, you know, that is considered as production of gas. That isn't actually. What happens is the baby imbibes a lot of air, and that air can escape through the bottom or can escape through the top. So these are all within normal limits. So you must know what abnormal things are. If the baby is not sucking at all, refusing feeds one after another, that's abnormal. If the baby is very lethargic, very drowsy, you are not able to wake the baby up, that's abnormal. If the baby is vomiting 90% of the feeds, or the vomit contains something which is yellowish in color, that's abnormal. If the baby changes color, becomes blue or become very yellow, that's abnormal. So these are times when the parents should contact the doctors. Now, as far as routine care is concerned, there are a few things I would like to mention. Number one is breastfeeding, and that's very important. The mother should try to breastfeed as much as possible. And when you are breastfeeding, you sit on a chair, make sure that you are comfortable, hold the baby properly, and give a breastfeed. And the baby must be awake. The baby shouldn't be sleeping. So if you wake the baby up, pat the baby up, wake the baby up, give a little bit of burping, and feed. Wake the baby up and feed. That's the way you do it, and do it 15-20 minutes on each breast. And how frequently it is? When the baby cries, I would feed the baby. But if the baby is not feeding, for example, in about 4-5 hours or so, and especially in a smaller wee baby, then definitely I would wake the baby and feed. But otherwise, it's a basically on-demand feeding. The mother should consume lots of fluids, a healthy diet, and make sure that she doesn't take smoke or have alcohol and other things like that. The baby should have a daily bath. Remember, hygiene is of primary importance. We should wash our hands properly or use those disinfectant liquids nowadays available. So we should use them liberally. We should make sure that the baby is clean, the baby has a regular soap bath, and the baby is kept well groomed and cared for. The baby can have a little bit of oil massage half an hour to 1 hour before bath, and can have a lotion massage of the body as well as the face after bath and at bedtime. The cord should be taken care of. Appropriate antibiotic ointments need to be applied for the first month of age. In essence, there are three important things one should remember. Number one is breastfeeding. If at all the baby has to have bottle feed, the bottles need to be cleaned properly, sterilized properly, and the water needs to be properly boiled. But I would advise not to give bottle feeds if the baby can be sustained on breastfeeds. Number two is keep the baby clean, keep the mother clean, and thirdly, use that sense which is most uncommon to common people, or use your common sense. If you are feeling that a baby is not well as a mother, then the baby needs to see a doctor. Thank you.